Hey guys, found something at a thrift store that I know that somebody would be interested in. This is a ExploreNet. I'm guessing it's a repeater. I'm not too sure why it was there, but I'm actually glad it was. I paid $14 for it. I know it's got a nice antenna in it. Also, if I can get it to work, I would actually keep it as is, but if not, it has room where I could, say, put a router in it and have it outside and basically just run power to it, and you can have it as a repeater that where it's networked to your indoor router, and then it just basically repeats on the outside, which would work for outdoor use. But I figured I'd make a video and we'll pull the sucker apart. It's in good shape. Warranty stickers are still on it. Let's dig into it and see what we got. Okay, let's try power drill. Cut the seals on it. Stuff like this I get a little bit excited about. You also find these, you'll see them as stop signs. Not stop signs, but street lights. You'll see them hanging on a pole. Yeah, so I'm not too sure why it was at the thrift store. I was quick to grab it. It's noisy. Something's living in there. It's dead. There's your ground strap. I actually found the PDF to one of these that I'll share in the description. And I'll go over the model number. Actually, I'll do the model number now. It's not easy. It's just really, really fine writing there. Let's see. Model number is WLTMS-110. Product number is ExploreNet FWL3500-6. And it's made in China. 0.27 amps at 56 volts. I think that's probably the maximum voltage, but whatever. Well, these things are pretty powerful. I found some pictures of this, the inside of it, on the internet, and the antenna layout's pretty nice. There should be a rubber seal around here too. It's probably not going to be easier to pop it open. There we go. Am I missing one? Yeah, there's two screws underneath the seal. Yep. Alright. Oh, here we go. Whoa, check that out. That's pretty cool. That's a killer. Someone's been in here. You can see their fingerprints, but then again, it could be in when it was manufactured. But that's pretty cool. That's a killer Wi-Fi antenna. That'll $14 alone for the Wi-Fi antenna. It was more than worth it. Whoa. Don't want to strip the hell out of that. Each one of these has a screw? Wow. If I could just take those out there. And I'm going to try taking these four out instead of all these little ones here. I don't think we have to take all these out. Like, you could, like, literally print this out on a PCB and make your own antenna. It's pretty easy to do. Mask it out. I want to see what the board looks like. And how it gets power. I'm guessing it gets power through the network cable, but I found a pinout for it, but it doesn't really show what the input-output and the power connection is. If I can get the power up even with the bench power supply, that'd be nice. See what it does, how it lights up. If it works at all, could have been struck by lightning for all I know. Pop the seal off here, get it out of the way. Oh, it's gonna come out. Cool. Wow, that's cool. So the Wi-Fi cables are the little more. I don't know what you call them, but they just basically push on the on the card. You can just pull them off. Yeah. Lots of room in here if you want to put another router in here. Just saying. So like there the antenna alone is what's worth the $14. You can do a lot with that. Here's the board. Cool. Oh, look at that. It's got a, there's a card in it still on there. A SIM card. I wonder what it is. Oh, yeah, we're going to have to pull that out. So if you could get this to power up, you could set this up with some type of phone thing where you have internet. I don't know why there's a SIM card in there. Guess I gotta look up the instructions on it. It's gotta come out there. Just by looking at it, I'm pretty sure I could get this thing to power up just the way it is. There we go. That comes right off. It's heat sink down, so that must generate a lot of heat. So grab a magnifying glass here, see if I can see any markings on it. Nope. It just says, WETMS-10-RF module V101, 19KG8400R rows. That's about it. Cool. I wonder if the lid comes off. And it does. There's your transmitter. G1, G2. Board. There's a flash on it. Reset switch and this little card here. I'll drop this in the phone, see what it does. basically, it's just got their logo and some kind of product number on it. That's about it. Where could I hook this up to get it to power up? Well, give me a minute and see if I can find somewhere to power it up. Well, going by the solder mask, these two here are rectifiers. There's a dual there. I don't know what these two, these four here are for, but if you look at the solder mask through the light, they come around to the middle there, and then they go to the network socket. So we probably could get it to power up just by right there, hooking it up in that area there, which we're obviously going to try. I mean, I can't use this. I would like to, but I know there's parts missing. It's going to be, you couldn't just plug this right into a network socket. It's not going to work that way. This thing runs on 80 volts, so it's just not going to work. And there is a little bit of water damage, as you can see it on the end of the RJ47, whatever it is, the socket there, the network socket. There's some water damage, so it's likely been shorted out at one time and damaged, because if you've got 80 volts running through that little socket and it shorts to all pins, it will cook this transmitter and everything else. So, because it's AC that's going in and then it's DC coming out past those rectifiers. So we're going to hook it up to the bench power supply, see if we can even get the status lights to work. Kind of cool. Okay, I found a place we can go off. If you look at it right about here, there's a printing on the PCB where there's supposed to be a socket there. That bypasses the route, the rectifiers, and that's where you'd have your DC plugged directly into the board. So we can probably just go right off of that, because those traces are going to where they're supposed to be, and you can definitely tell where the negative and positive is. So we'll try that. Well, it definitely jumps. I mean, it definitely runs on 80 volts. I've got it at 32 volts, and it's not even drawing any EMA at all. Nothing. So we're gonna try. I'll try my battery at 60 volts. See if that works. Amperage might get something out of it if it doesn't blow up. Well, it works at 60 volts or 50 volts. Blue light on their diagram says it's powered up. I don't want to hook the module up to it, because without the antenna you'll fry for sure. But they show you how to network to it. You could plug a tower right into it right now, and it'd act as a router. So I don't know what to do with it. I wanted to show you the insides of it, but really what I want to do is gut one of my routers upstairs and put it inside the box. So I guess we'll leave it for another project. But I figured I'd show you the insides. It's pretty cool. Like I said, for $14, the antenna alone is well worth it. What I'm gonna do with it. Well, you guys didn't think that was it, did you? Hell no. I want to keep going. Okay, so green, blue is power good. Green is SIM detected, which is that SIM there. So it seems to be working with that. I'm gonna try. Actually, I'll bring all this upstairs, and we're going to plug it directly into my router, and see if we get some different status lights. There's the status lights. Network. I got a blue or blue, yellow, and green. Yellow means connected to the network. Obviously, blue means it's powered up, and green means it's booted up off the SIM card. I can't find anything on the network or anything here that. That comes up would be strong enough to be that. So it's configured in a certain way that'll only work with their setup. I don't even see it transmitting anything that would I could try to, like, it would be a really strong signal, and I got nothing here. So. And I know the transmitter in it is working, because it gets warm. It's heat-sinked, so I figured I'd try it. That's about as far as I'm going to go. I'm gonna stick a router in it, which will be quite easy to do. Later, guys.